Good afternoon, Deep South, back in the woods again. Today's Saturday, October 4th. Got here last night, about 5:30. Seems like every time I come here, it's just got through raining, but we had some awesome thunderstorms yesterday, and I thought it was going to rain all night, but it didn't. Set up camp, very warm and muggy. It wasn't hot, but it was very muggy. So I didn't bother with any fire. And got some Mountain House chicken teriyaki. So this was supper last night. From what I gather, I wanted it, so they listened. And these are the new vacuum sealed ones that are compacted down. They're only about that big in your pack. So I'd never seen them before. I stopped in Sports Authority, got a couple, and that was supper. I didn't eat supper till about 11 o'clock. Just wasn't hungry. So I fixed supper, made some tea, went to bed. Most of the night I just spent sitting in the chair listening. Lots of coyotes, lots of owls, screech owls, barn owls. What else? Unidentified noises in the woods. When I went to bed, it was 72, and got down to 61 during the night. And all I had was my poncho liner, and I wasn't all that warm. I actually woke up cold. But I had a blanket with me. If I got time, I don't spend a lot of time on some other videos. I'll show you the camp set up. But I got some visitors coming in. I've got a friend from work, Scott, and his two children. They're coming in, and they're going to spend Saturday night with me tonight. They want to learn how to make fires. Trevin wants to learn how to trap, but I don't think he's quite ready for that. And if something crawls across the screen, it's a love bug. They're not completely gone. But they're not as bad as they were a couple weeks ago. The mosquitoes were horrendous last night. I had to get out the thermocell. I didn't have a fire, so I didn't keep them away, but the thermocell worked. So what I thought I was going to do today, since I slept all morning and then processed wood while it was cool. It's 2 o'clock now and I haven't had anything to eat other than a couple cups of coffee. I'm going to do another bushcraft breakfast. Last time I kind of did it UK style because I wanted to try out the HP sauce on a bacon bunny, Butty. What I'm going to do this time is I'm going to do it Deep South style, the way I make my fried egg sandwiches and bacon sandwiches. There's something else I was going to say. But that's what I'm going to do. Oh, forgot. The way I'm going to do it, though, was special. I finally got something in. So this is first fire, first light. What you call it, fill the telescope. This, I guess, you call a stove, first fire, first light. I don't know. But this is my Bushcraft Essential, the XL. Really looking forward to this. I've heard so much about it from Mr. Scooty, from Foxy, lots of people. So I got to try it out. It did take a long time. It took almost 2 weeks to get here, though. Don't know why it took so long. Hint, I should have gotten it through Amazon. It would have saved me $50. I got it directly from the store. I don't know if they're going to be mad at me for saying that, but through Amazon, it was $50 cheaper to send to the United States or in the United. I guess they're already here. I don't know, but it would have saved me $50. But I ordered directly from the store. But I really can't complain. I'm happy. So far. So I'm going to reposition the camera and maybe not do a lot of talking because it's windy and kind of warm and buggy as usual in Florida. And I'm going to do this video. Hard to do because I'm in the sun and I can't see. But I spent this morning processing wood while it was cool. I got everything set up in my bush kitchen. Deep South bush kitchen table. My stool, because my knees cannot stand stooping down. My ice chest. And ice milk crate with a old, that's a really cool grill. It's cast in sand. The grill screwed up because I got it too hot and it actually melted because the grill's made out of aluminum too. But the stove itself or the grill itself, it's cast aluminum and sand. But I'm gonna use that for a base for the bush box. Okay, testing to see if I can still get, there's my Gransford Brooks hatchet. Get everything in frame and hopefully I'll start soon. Oh, here we go. I didn't bring any cotton balls, so all I got is dryer lint and Vaseline. I'm gonna try that. Hopefully it works. I've tried to avoid the sun all day. There's not much shade here. I love this pouch it comes in. It's very handy, very neat. Comes with the grill, which I won't be using. The trivets fit in the back. Brilliant. I got the two extra. And Bob's your uncle. I like saying that. Well, that fits pretty good. Pretty stable. I bet this is going to be messy. And windy. I apologize for the wind. There's nothing I can do about it though. First try. It's a good looking lanyard too, isn't it? Just right for this. Hot. Very hot. I went and Vaseline worked well. Man, that's just a cat's ass, isn't it? Oh man, I just love this. Love my lanyard too. And this from Johnny Bushcraft just works superbly. Like a little tie clasp. Hot. Well, I'm gonna get this going. And then I'm gonna cook. This will give the people in the UK an opportunity to see how we eat. I guess it's one of the reasons we're out here, to exchange cultures. I put the windscreen around this because I got 10 to 15 mile an hour gust. I've had this, but I haven't used it. It's a flat griddle, and this thing is ancient. It's a Wagner Ware from Sydney. And since I had company coming, I wanted something larger, but not too big. And I like it because it's flat. And I don't have to use the trivets on it. Anyway, we're going to see how it works out. Not too stable. But it'll do. I'll make it work. Let it get hot. Man, this stove is just superb. Love it. Back out with the whisk. That is the handiest little knife. Lots of bacon. Man, it's windy. Not real good if you don't have a level platform. All that grease goes to one side. Learned a lot about bacon. That's the last time I did a video out here. But our bacon's not the same as British bacon because it's not cut from the same piece of meat. Ours comes from the belly, theirs comes closer to the loin. I don't know what it is. I have never liked runny yolk. Ever since I was a kid, I think it grossed me out for some reason. I do like it in my eggs all mixed up. Man, it's windy. Blowing my windshield all over the place. Impatient. I love bugs are back. I mean, they're everywhere now. Fried egg sandwich, deep south style. A bun, I usually use white bread, just plain old white bread. But after last time I used these dusted Kaiser rolls, I really, really like those. Mayonnaise. Oops. Mayonnaise. Eggy waggy. And I generally only carry two spices, salt, pepper, well, three, salt and pepper, and Tony's. My bag's got a hole in it. So, mayonnaise, egg, Tony's. And Tabasco. I guess my Tabasco would be your HP. Because I got to have it. Now the bacon. And that's that. Deep South. Bacon egg sandwich. It's difficult filming by yourself. I guess the rest of the day will be spent hunting shade. Now yesterday it got up to 70. No, I think it got up to 81 yesterday. And to tonight, we're supposed to get down to 41. Which the weather forecast has changed since I got here, because when I was on my way here, the weather forecast said 47. Well, there's my sandwich. Ah, Deep South style. And that's the way you do it. It's awesome. Love it. Y'all have a good one. See you on the flip side. Might be doing some videos of the kids, trying to teach them how to start fires later. But this is the first time I've been camping with somebody in ages. I mean, like, ages, because I always go solo. But I haven't camped out with any. Well, actually, it was 3 years ago. The Astronomy Club, we camped out. So, maybe I'll see y'all tonight. Y'all take care. Thank you for watching. Stay safe. Stay strange.